All right, we talked about his great cookbook, and now James Farmer is treating us to a sampling of what kind of magic he can work from his recipes from A Time to Cook. Okay, and I need to tell you this, because I was laughing over there off camera when you guys were like, bacon grease and duck fat. And here's what I can really, really get behind about Southern cooking is it was the original farm-to-table concept.
Completely.
Where it's like such a cool thing now.
It's so chic. Garden the glass, seed the spoon. Honey, I grew up that way.
Right. You said, what did you say? If you've got a plot or a pot?
A pot or plot, whatever you got. You can grow something.
And there's no excuse not to just have it in your own backyard.
Absolutely. You're exactly right. There's a couple myths with Southern cooking that, you know, you have to get up at 5 in the morning, you have to cook all day. Well, you know, what's amazing is that if it's fresh and tastes good, it's just very few ingredients, very few prep, and that's the best idea.
Yes.
Sure, fried chicken is great and cornbread. Don't eat it for every meal.
Right.
But there's some things like chicken salad that can be very healthy. One thing that I learned from my grandmother, from my Mimi, was that you want to feast, one, visually first. We eat with our eyes first. Second off is that you can do something that's simple and very seasonal.
Right.
So here we are coming into fall, and when I think fall, I'm thinking about cranberries and pumpkin seeds and pecans. Chicken salad is your foundation. It's your building block, because you can use things in the wintertime with parsley and chervil. In the springtime, throw berries into it. Summertime, put some peaches. For fall, it's apples, pecans, pumpkin seeds.
And those fresh ingredients, we always forget how good they are for you. And I know that pumpkin seeds and walnuts, both really good for your skin,
complexion. They are so great for you.
So how did you,
this is a quick fix chicken salad. My friends at Central Market have been so great to me. I'm thinking we need one of those in Georgia. But they were so funny, because they said, well, we've got a chicken salad. If you just need to bring something really quick, either make your own day ahead. If not, do your favorite store-bought. And what I love about a simple chicken salad is it's just good roasted chicken with a good dressing.
Mm-hmm.
Then you doctor it up with ingredients. So this is a traditional, good old-fashioned chicken salad. And then I've taken, instead of a cracker or bread, we have apples. So this is a Fuji apple, which is really sweet. And then this is a Granny Smith. So it's a sweet and tart mixed with a little bit of the creaminess of chicken salad. Then you can top it off. Now, did you ever eat ants on a log at a picnic or growing up?
With the raisins?
Exactly. It's kind of like ants on a log here. So you take an apple and you put a little bit of chicken salad right on top of it. And what I love to do is to like keep the chicken salad a little bit chunky. And then you just kind of sprinkle on what you want. Do you want some pecans on there, or do you want some pumpkin seeds on there?
Oh, these are pecans, not walnuts.
I'm from Georgia.
Of course. What was I thinking? A southern recipe without pecans? Do you say pecan or pecan?
I say pecan. And that's the way that we really say it.
Did your Mimi say pecan?
Mimi said pecan too. So we talk like how we were raised. So you throw it all together, and you know, something else that my Mimi said was, if you cut it small and put it on a silver platter, it looks great. And so if you're entertaining, this is a great way to entertain. This bite right here is wonderful. You know, some people are trying to cut out a calorie or a carb here and there. Well, this is a great way to do it right here.
It's like a little party in your mouth.
There it is.
I'm interested about your opinions about portion size. Because like you just said, if you make something real pretty that tastes good and you put it on a silver platter, it's all anybody needs. Do you think like portion sizes are sort of out of control now?
Well, what's amazing to me is, and it's hard to hold this and not devour it while we're talking, but I was also taught not to talk with my mouth full, so I'm going to try not to. But portion size is amazing. As you see, I'm a big farm boy, so it took a lot of portions to get me to this size, but it will also take a lot of portions to get me to the width, a great wide size, too. I think if we eat until we are comfortable, that's wonderful. And then sometimes just taking a breath, and you realize that I'm very comfortable. Because if you take a breath and you're uncomfortable, you've gone way too far.
Then that's a problem, right?
Exactly. Just enjoy. Just take a few bites, enjoy it, eat it. And it's a great way to be healthy, especially when the things have great flavor.
Come on, Susie. She's going to take that off your hand.
Lordy.
I'll force myself.
You can use this tasty recipe at your holiday get-togethers, or do what James suggested. Like if you're short on time, go get your favorite chicken salad and do it up with the toppings. It's so fantastic. We will have the recipe for you, though, for his chicken salad on our website, thebroadcasttv.com. Just click on today's links and find recipes there.
Can I say one thing? This book is a poem. I promise you.
It's
the
beautiful.
Way it's laid out, everything, it's all the old recipes brought back that we haven't had for so long. And can I have a free copy?
Of course.
Will you sign it for her, too?
I'm glad to.
Okay,
glad
when we
to.
Come back,
thanks,
one last look at how the Kids Kids Group is doing as they work to reach their fundraising goal today. Courtney's out there. We'll check back in with her when we come back. Stay with us.